Good night, everyone. Good early morning. I think it's April 6 or something. I don't know. I'm at the Amsterdam red light district, and this doesn't look like the post-corona world at all. Like the world before the corona crisis. Everything changed. Normally spoken, at this time of the night, there are screaming tourists and girls and all kinds of things. Now, this is the only thing which matters, 1.5 meter distance. The first part of this video will be in English. After that, there will be a break. And after that, the rest will be here. Respect our sex workers. They keep women safe and men happy. Well, I would say that's a little bit opinionated, but well, it's fine. Oh, here. What's that? This is not a Yellowfest video. Normally spoken, I'm making Yellowfest videos. But Yellowfest do not have an opinion about prostitution. They are not for or against. Yet, during the crisis, we do have an opinion about it because we do not want to die. And here, well, whatever, it's a funny person. It's not my job anyway, I'm just here to make a video. And then based on what people see in the video, they can act. Now, this is the red light district and I was leaving all my things unattended. So, let's walk back and see if everything is still there. Look, someone parked a bike. Look, another red light. Here, there's a red light on my bike. I think I'm going to offer storytelling, because with 1.5 meter distance you need to tell very nice stories that make lonely women feel better. So that's what the red light is for. Naughty stories. Naughty, well, sexy stories. And the white light is for those who want Jesus stories, but I'm not going to do that in here. Because we are in here. Now, there is a regulation here. And it says, no alcohol in public spaces, fine, 95 euros. And what do we see here? Alcohol. Yet, this is not a public space because I marked it. This is my private space. Now, this is just a video. This is not a serious, proposal. Someone is passing by. Only the shoes will be visible, so it's not all that. Alleen je schoenen staan in beeld, hoor.
1.5 meter afstand, hè?
Wel thuis, man. Okay. Amsterdam is still Amsterdam, everyone is relaxed. You might say that the red light district changed a tiny little bit. It belongs to the people who live here again. So, let's see. Ah, yes, we have noise. Now, what's the idea of the video today? It's not an Amsterdam Yellowfest video. What's that? Well, it is what it is. The people here are used to noise. So there will be noise.
Thank you.
Look, this is how strong the light is of the camera.
Bedtime stories. Anyone? 1.5 meter distance. Anyone? All money will be donated to a good purpose. It's not for me. Sexy bedtime stories. Well, I also have a plan.
I also have a plan B for the video, in case plan A doesn't work for this part of town. Sexy bedtime stories only for the girls. You can also drop me a PM on Facebook. Just look me up on Facebook, try to find me, because I'm not going to tell my name. Because this is just a prank. Now, yesterday something interesting happened. Something really interesting happened. There was this... I was biking from the forest to the night shop. And I saw a plastic bag laying on the ground. And it's in Amsterdam. So, look, as you can see, we are in Amsterdam with very normal rules. And I'm in Amsterdam and I'm busy trying to get customers for sexy bedtime stories. 1.5 meter distance, please. Only for ladies. And I mean, bedtime stories, right? I didn't read anything in the Bible about this. And of course, I'm taking it serious, you know, of all holy books. It's a prank. We're in the red light district, so 1.5 meter distance. So I was thinking, let's be creative. Just imagine boys everywhere at all windows offering sexy bedtime stories. 1.5 meter distance.
I mean, we need new ideas, right? For after the Corona crisis. Before the Corona crisis, of course, no one should take advantage. But after the Corona crisis, everything will be different. So, if we have males here reading sexy bedtime stories, then we will not have yelling British, or sorry, it's not British tourists, it's all kinds of tourists here. And we will have a completely different crowd. We will have big groups of British and other girls yelling and screaming here. We want bedtime stories! We want bedtime stories! Ah, there's police coming, I think. Well, I might just as well go to the police. Ah, police is leaving. So, I was finding this, and it's rather interesting. As you can see, it says air. It says air. But here it says revelations. That's very interesting. So in this plastic bag I was seeing laying on the streets, I was finding they are coming anyway, I think. Right now they are turning. Now they're just passing by. So I was finding it, and I was a bag on the middle of the road, and it says revelations. So I was thinking, and I'm to keep an eye on the police. It's I think the police is making certain and no one is working here or something. So it says revelations. So I was, it's Amsterdam, I took it with me. When you find something, you take it with you, you cure it for others. If this is your sweater, thanks. But this is not your sweater, because I assume that for all still active yellow pests in the Netherlands and also in other places, something dropped out of the sky from heaven. It fell on the ground on a place where they would be expected to be 5 minutes later. And well, this is what fell down for me. Now, the recording is going just fine. And I will give it a little bit more angle. So this is what came. My theory is, until proven otherwise, this is not exact science, but it's a theory, that this dropped from the heaven, from above, for me, revelations. So this, of course, is a story. It's only a story. It's you that can decide if the story is true or not, not me. I'm just the storyteller here, okay? I'm here in the red light district offering my services for lonely women, sexy bedtime stories, 1.5 meter distance, please. A police woman came. I think she still has cold feet. Maybe she will come back later. We'll see. But anytime. Anyway, revelations. This is rather interesting. And also today, as I said, I'm not here as a yellow vest, because the yellow vests are not pro or against prostitution. For what am I here? I might call it Amsterdam Partisans, I might call it Amsterdam Bedtime Stories, I might call it Amsterdam Bedtime Stories and Amsterdam Revelations, because the revelations, I still need to look up what the word means exactly in English, but I think it means openbaringen. This means define statements. Well, if I make define statements, I'm agnostic, so I have no idea. If I'm making this up myself, or is there someone inspiring me or something? I don't know. You know, I'm just the messenger. Please don't shoot the messenger. Now, this is the Amsterdam sexy bedtime stories area now. And it's bad business today. There is really completely no one. Only one bloke came. I don't think he came for bedtime stories. And he was drunk beyond belief. Now, bedtime stories, they come with drinks. The police has come, so I can put the alcohol back. And, well, the people here, they feel like, well, yes, yes, this is my neighborhood again. There's noise in the middle of the night. Finally, I can sleep again.
Because the bedtime stories, they are going to come with some noise. They are going to get down, you know, get down. Of course, the windows will remain to be open, because we need to make certain that people keep 1.5 meter distance. And if they don't keep 1.5 meter distance, bring your camera. What's next? Basically, I only came here to show the red light district in the corona crisis. I walked into this and the entire Amsterdam bedtime stories area, it came up here. This is not a revelation, because revelations are supposed to have a deeper meaning. This is just a useful business ID. You know, the kind of business we will have after the corona crisis needs to be not parasite business. The parasite business was before the corona crisis, the parasite business of the super rich. After the corona crisis, we want to have social business models. So not the way it was before, but the way it's going to be after. And I would say sexy bedtime stories. That's the idea. And yellow vests are not for or against prostitution, but actual prostitution. If the majority of the people in Amsterdam wants it, please, in brothels or so, in a side street of a side street, or not out in the open. I mean, this, we are talking about women here, but here they are like chickens on the market. You know, I'm not saying you should sell chickens on the market like this. That's not what I'm saying. It's to compare. Now we're going to make noise again.
Geen pretentie, geen meer. Geen pretentie, geen meer.
Now, I'm seeing some victims of the red light district crisis here. Eendjes, little duckies. Well, these ones are not done on one banana today. None of them want bananas. Yet, give it some time. Give it some time. Because the entire red light district is coming alive now. The birds are making noise. So when the birds are making noise, a lot of other birds are coming. You see? Oh, now they're going to fight for it. So the birds are back on the red light district. Aha, and the rats are here too. I'm seeing a rat here. This was not the ID. I'm not all too worried about the rats. Aha, there's a black bird here. I don't know the name of this bird in Dutch, so I don't know it in English. But the black bird he likes the bananas. Or sea. Well, it's birds, so it's all sea. The birds are back in the red light district. And they are not super hungry, so there is no big problem. That's suicide, then you're killing yourself. Relax, people. If you don't stress out and stay away from the aspirin, then 99% of cancer survives, as long as there is no cure. So, and if you have plenty of intensive care and so on. Now, this area is not for the revelations. It's for the basic activities. And one of the basic activities in life is eating. Now, that's the next topic. Well, ¿Qué pasa, gringos? Um Corona is not the... There are rats here, so I need to... if you have seen a rat eating my food, please tell me. But I will adapt the style a little bit. Now, if you are sick, there are all kinds of sicknesses which can kill you. For example, if you leave your... Calm, rustig, rustig, vrede op aarde. Rustig nou, er is genoeg voor iedereen. Okay, I hope you're quiet for 5 minutes. Okay, corona is not the only illness. There are all kinds of illnesses. And some illnesses kill 1% of those who get it. Some illnesses kill 50%. But there's one illness which kills all of us, and that's capitalism. That's for the regulations. That's not for the basic practices. But for the basic practices, food, people, food. Now, with corona, I'm reading about it since late January. When I was reading that an entire city in China was in lockdown, I was alerted. Hallo, rustig. Rustig nou. They know I'm only bluff and don't do anything now, so it doesn't work anymore. Well, it works a bit. Now, I've been reading it ever since Wuhan, because it's very special. It's very, not special, it's very remarkable when an entire city goes on lockdown. So already since late January, early February, I've been making a lot of noise in the Facebook group Intercultural Amsterdam. People, close these bars. People, don't go to the stadiums. People, stop organizing events. I kept going for a week, 10 days. No one listened, no one responded. Some people I know very well, I was sending them a kind mail. Well, there's only one death in Barcelona, so we will do what the authorities say. That's not a good idea, people. The elite, the capitalistic elite, does not care about you at all. They only care about making money on you. That's all they care about. Of course, this is only 90% of the highest part, of the upper part of the current world order. There's a world government. It's called the GDB. GDB. That's G20 Davos Bilderberg. This is the world government. There's nothing secret about it. Everyone knows what they're doing, where they're doing it, what they're doing. This is the world government. Now, the world government has a kind of senate. And this senate is the super rich. Now, over 90% of the super rich people are super predators. They are farming us. And if needed, hunting us. So we have a crisis now. So in a crisis, we turn the thing upside down. After the crisis, not during the crisis. The super rich are on the menu now. Here, I have a menu, the super rich are on it. Food, you know, food, food. But anyway, let's deal with this corona crisis first. People want to know, what if I'm in the middle of nowhere, in a village with 200 people and plenty of livestock for 200 years, but there is not one single doctor. We don't have internet, we know nothing. The only thing we have is your movie. You're in big shit now. But I have advice anyway. Instead of water, when you get sick, instead of water, drink this. It's tasty, it's nice, and it has a lot of vitamin C. So when you are a little bit sick, drink this. And when you are a little bit sick, stay in bed all day, relax. And also, connect to your deepest instincts, to your survival instincts. They will tell you, stay in bed, think about all the things you are going to do after the disease is over, after you have defeated it. Relax, stay in bed. Go to the toilet, of course. Don't go to the toilet in bed. That's a little bit too much work for your family members who are still with you. Or if you live alone, for you only. And drink this instead of water. Drink this. The The immune system of the body loves this. When corona is the enemy, it just loves it. You will feel it straight away, you will feel better because of it. Now what's the next song? That's not the next song. That's not the next song. That's not the next song. This is okay. You will feel better. Someone I know very well has done it like this. And it was over in 3-4 days. That's half of the people who are getting it don't even notice they're getting it, and they get antivirus things in their body. So then they can wait for the update. That's just being cynical. Now, other than that, of course, it's very important to also have your normal food. Like if you're a vegetarian, don't eat meat, but you didn't do that anyway. If you're not a vegetarian, nice hamburger. Are there any birds here? Where's my shotgun? Now I'm scared, you're saying. Nothing to be scared of. Apples. Apples. Yeah, sinaasappeltjes. Mandarijntjes, we call it in Dutch. I have no idea what you call it in English. But this thing, mandarijntjes, but in English, please. Eat healthy. Eat healthy. If you do not have it, you might get it in the months to come. Eat healthy. Eat healthy. Eat healthy stuff. Also very important, if you are going to buy Coca-Cola, keep the bottle. Coca-Cola is nice, but keep the bottle and refill it 60 times with water and drink it. And only then buy your next bottle of Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola says, thanks for the advertisement. You just destroyed 60% of our turnover. So, what more do we have? Okay, 60 bedtime stories. You know, I am not doing this kind of sexy bedtime stories, but I came well prepared. I came well prepared. For this I'm going to change the angle. Let's see how much time I have used. 15 minutes. I came well prepared because sometimes there are junkies here in the middle of the night. The last time I was in the center, one approached me. And this is why I have this. I don't really feel like dancing.
hersenen, nou eens eerlijk vooruit dan. Er vielen misschien nog over te praten, maar een stiekem racist die iedereen is, die kan er alleen nog maar haten en haten.
We zijn nou Hitler, we zijn nou Hitler.
Ze zijn niet sterk, maar verspreiden zich snel.
We zijn nou Hitler, we zijn nou Hitler.
Je ziet ze niet vaak, maar ze zijn het toch wel.
Ik zal waar heen, jongen. Ik stel waarheen schulden, waarheen schulden. Salander ben.
Hallo. Zo, nou we komen te bike over de Red Light District. Wait, wait, check if I have my keys with me. Yes. Don't film the curls. Daar is een curl after all. Zo, I'm going to stop biking. Ja, I will continue biking. Pourquoi ce charme tu recommences? Je ne suis qu'un être sans importance. There is an intelligent lockdown in Amsterdam. I'm not going to talk this about this in this video, but there's an intelligent lockdown and not a hardcore lockdown. Now here. Well, looks normal for corona time. Looks normal for the corona crisis. This is the current normal in Amsterdam, people. Now, what we're going to see next is the Damplein. And I'm 43 minutes taped now. I think 110, 115 is more or less the maximum. Now what's happening here? Look there. It kind of looks strange. Maybe the intelligent lockdown has small pockets. Bikes everywhere. But anyway. All this is not my concern. My concern is to go to the place out here, public toilet. My concern is to go to the place for the revelations. Look, hotel. All closed. So, we left the red light district now. I think. Oh, wait. No, we're still on it. Everything is closed. Here's the bridge. Curtains closed. Uh-oh, what's happening here? Okay. So far for the red light district. Now we're going to Damplein and then we're going to the place for the revelations. On the other place, I will have to keep the voice down because it's normal at the red light district that there's noise. This is not good. I also need to put new songs on this.
I keep telling myself every day.
Ik ben Bulgaris, magistralis, en ik kom niet in
the national monument has been closed, has been fenced now for maintenance. Look, fenced for maintenance. Ah, there's the police. Fenced for maintenance. This is, well, this is better, I think, with the police. I will not put them in visible on the camera. Here, there are two people there. Maybe that's a topic of interest for the police. I don't know. Here's the night bus. And there is an ambulance.
Ik ben Bulgarisch, magistralisch, en ik reed op in mijn moederdroom. Ik ben Bulgarisch, magistralisch, en een zonder de maskool.
It's not allowed to walk around with a camera in your hand here.
Door de bossen van de landenroom.
Abu, Abu, Abu.
Je wilt niet steken, vullen en te doen. En achter
de tijd
kom ik in mijn hoofd. Is bouw van een spielberg.
I'm not here today for a demonstration. I have no idea if they know who I am. But this is one of my targets if I am a yellow vest. Today I'm not a yellow vest. I have no idea what I am today. I'm going to make this up later. But I'm not a yellow vest today. Because yellow vests are not for all occasions. It's too simple. Well, here we have Beurs van Berlage, and this is most, well, this is the place where Gele has his Amsterdam Beursplein. This is where all the bullshit started. The stock exchange, speculation, get rich, hype, make it bigger, make it stronger, make it grow, yippee! Let's destroy the entire world and call it free markets. Yeah. 50 minutes. I want to stop this video in 20 minutes. Well, 30 minutes max. So, police is gone. Let's bike again. As you can see, Amsterdam is unbelievably empty, and even though it's 10 to 5 in the morning, this is not normal for Amsterdam. Normally spoken at 10 to 5 in the morning on Saturday, it's crowd everywhere. Well, normally spoken, the old normal. This is the Corona crisis normal. Oh wait, where am I going again? I'm going to the place of the revelations. I'm going to the oldest part of Amsterdam, and then I will put the music down or maybe out. Now, the Amsterdam already existed before there was Amsterdam. Right now I'm biking on a dike. And this dike is less old than the village at the end of this dike. At the end of this dike there used to be a village. And this village is called Terp. It was well, it more or less was on a kind of beach, what we call wadden in here. I think it was kind of a beach, maybe a lagoon, and there were some farms and so, and an iron makery, smederij we call it in Dutch. And people were doing fine, they were fishing, most likely selling a lot of fish to the farmers on the other side of IJ in Waterland. And it was calm, nice, peaceful, a good life, until in the area where I just was, people started buying a fortress. The Hollandic feudals came. Before the Hollandic feudals came, here, this was the center. Hey, that's nice. There's a chair for me. That's very nice indeed. Okay, no music now. Well, whoa. Everything is still okay. There's a car here somewhere, I can hear it. But that's fine. So, bike put down. Succeeded. It might be a car, it can also be somewhere else, something else. Look at it. For me. I might even take it home. Why not? Yeah. Yeah, all for me. Okay, put the camera down. Now, this is the oldest part of Amsterdam. This is Amsterdam before it was Amsterdam. And the West Frisians, this was a West Frisian village. The West Frisians never asked the Holland of Beurdels to come. They came anyway. And there has been fights late on. I think other West Frisians burnt the entire place down, but this didn't help. I'm not thinking burning things down is a good thing. If you come to this place, you can see that here there's a street where it goes down slowly. This is not normal for a dike. So this is not a dike, this is an artificial hill called Terp. Now, Revelations. Already for 7,000-8,000 years, the power of people who exploit other people has been rising. Now, if enough people want it, we are at a historical turning point. The power of the people who exploit others has never been bigger than it is now. At the moment, but that's the moment when they will implode. Because people who exploit, they have a stomach which always gets bigger. The more they eat, the bigger their stomach gets. And they have like a pit that's, I don't know what's the word in English, but this is a pit here. This is a pit where the water goes in. And they have this put, and this put, it has no bottom. So at the moment the super rich have all the power, they start sucking the entire earth empty. Because at a certain moment they have so much power that they keep sucking. But this is the revelation, if it's divine or not, or just a story, that's up to you, not up to me. Don't shoot the messenger. But at the moment they have so much power that no one can stop them anymore. There will be infighting, we are seeing this, infighting in between the billionaires. And there will be unrest. And some billionaires will be like, I prefer to be a millionaire and alive than a billionaire and to be dead. Other billionaires will be like, no, I'm hungry, I want more. I want to be the next president of the United States, then I have all the power, and then I can defend my interest everywhere. That's the mentality of some, and others are like, no, I prefer to be a millionaire, not a billionaire, and be alive. So, in this decade, there are big chances for the people who want to
blow the power of the super rich off the table worldwide in just one decade. You have seen how much change is possible worldwide. There are lockdowns everywhere. Well, not everywhere, but in all industrialized countries, there are lockdowns. In Amsterdam, an intelligent lockdown. In other, a very, very tough lockdown. But lockdowns everywhere. After the crisis, we can do a similar thing. We can tax the super rich with 50%, no, 75% of all the fortune above 1 million. And 100% of all the fortune above 100 million. So, no, 75% up to 1 million, all above 1 million, and an extra 25% above 100 million. All billionaires will be gone in one. We can do this. We can do this with strikes, we can do this with demonstrations. My revelation is, we can do this. We can do this. I'm not saying we are going to do this, but I'm saying we can do this. This is my revelation. I told you about the text, I told you about this thing that dropped out of the sky yesterday. That's my theory until it's proven otherwise. Revelation, it says here. Revelation. My revelation is, we can do this. My revelation is actual truth. I'm not saying we are going to do this, I'm saying we can do this. And I'm saying this on West Frisian soil, on the oldest part of Amsterdam, before it was Amsterdam, a man-made artificial hill made by men, maybe inspired by God above, but made by men. And Amsterdam belongs to the people who got here first. The West Frisians, the ruimer West Friesland, they are the authentic owners of Amsterdam. And we don't need Amsterdam back. It changed a lot. It has, Amsterdam is its own thing now. But what we are saying is, we want all the super rich out of Amsterdam. All of them. Out. Over and out. That's the revelation. This is what we want. We want all of them out. Will it happen? That's up to you. Now, I'm going to... the video is over. This was the first revelation from the oldest part of Amsterdam. Now I'm going to think about this chair. It's rather ambitious to take it home. No, it's easy. But I hope it will still be here in half an hour. I'm going to drop a note at my daughter's place, a note for my daughter. And the last part of the video will be me biking in the direction of where my daughter lives. She's 20 years now, 20 years. So I assumed if she sees this video, she can stand it. Daddy going to the red light district to feed birds. Well, but now the music. I really need new songs. There's the music. Give it some time. I'm not hearing anything. Well, let's see what can be the cause. Aha. Aha, I found the course. Told you so.
Dans le movie, une vie de route sur ma route. honte, oui, je ne compte plus les soucis de quoi devenir fou, oui, une vie de route.
Look, it's going down.
Sur ma route, oui, il y a eu du move, oui, de l'aventure dans le movie, une vie de route. Sur ma route, oui, je ne compte plus les soucis de quoi devenir fou, oui, une vie de route. Sur ma route.
There will not be any more information in this video. The information is over. Now it's just biking.
Sur ma route, j'ai eu des moments de doute. Je marchais sans savoir vers où. J'étais têtu, rien à foutre. Sur ma route, j'avais pas de bagage en soute. Et dans ma poche, pas un sou. Juste la famille entre nous.
Oh yes, I promised there would be ducks in the video. Well, sorry, blokes, next time.
L'impression que mon cœur en souffre, mais je suis sous anesthésie. Sur mon chemin, j'ai croisé pas mal d'anciens. Ils me parlaient du lendemain et que tout allait si vite. Ne me parle pas de nostalgie, parce que j'avoue que mon cœur est trop fragile. Je suis comme un pirate naufragé. Oui, mon équipage est plus qu'endommagé. Je sèche mes larmes, je baisse les armes. Je veux même plus savoir pourquoi ils me testent les autres. S'il n'y a plus rien à prendre, je sais qu'il me reste une chose. Et ma route, elle est trop longue, pas le temps de faire une chose. Sur ma route, oui, il y a eu du move, oui, de l'aventure dans le movie. Une vie de route. Sur ma route, oui, je ne compte plus les soucis. De quoi devenir fou, oui. Une vie de route. Sur ma route.
Ik wens jullie allemaal een prettig dienst. Altijd. It's also about respect. I saw the police cars, but I was thinking, well, the lights are off, there's nothing happening. And these are police guys doing their work. And in case the police would be a problem to me, well, here, look, a canon. Well, I'm on my way, as I said. It's about respect. If they see you stop biking, they are supposed to act when someone is biking with a camera in his hand. You want privacy channels, I'm hearing the crowd say. Well, okay, you will see channels. Minutes left, I think. Here's a channel for you. We're on a channel now. We want to see the moon! I'm hearing the crowd say. Oh, there's the moon. We want to see the headlights! No, 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 we have already been there. And I'm not going there anytime soon again. Yellow vests are not interested in the red lights. It's and also are not interested. It's not a yellow vest topic. Today was not a yellow vest movie. I have no idea what I'm going to call myself in this role. But not yellow vest.
Everybody, people, happy people, jumping on the party.